In 2021, when Windows 11 was first released, I tried installing it onto this handheld Sony VAIO from 2006. If you haven't seen that video, it was a great adventure, but the result was not the most usable operating system. Since then, many viewers have commented on using Tiny 11, a stripped-down version of Windows 11 that can run in as little as 2 GB of RAM and use less than 8 GB of storage space. That sounds pretty good. So in this video, I'm going to try Tiny 11, and the first computer I'm going to try it on is this VAIO. I'm setting everything up in a similar way that I did last time. I've seen that Tiny 11 removes the need for a trusted platform module, but when I run the installer, I get the same unsupported hardware block. This is not really a surprise, since the CPU and GPU and 1 GB of memory in this VAIO are all well below Microsoft's minimum requirements. But this is fine, because I can use everything I learned from the last time I installed Windows 11 on here. I just need to press Shift F10 to bring up the command prompt, and then set up the drive using DiskPart. I've done this so many times now that it's all very streamlined for me. I just need to clean the drive, convert to MBR, create a partition, set it as active, format the drive, and assign the letter C. If you're doing this for the first time, I've linked an article below that's really helpful. Then I just need to exit DiskPart, and now I use the DISM command. This will decompress all the Windows files and install them to the hard drive. I've done this a few times now, so I find it all fairly easy, especially thanks to another article that I've listed in the description below. I did have a small problem when it came to using BCD boot to install the boot files. I don't remember this being a problem last time, but I found if I went into DiskPart and set the partition back to active again, I was able to use BCD boot and get the system booting. But this is when the real challenge starts. I'm finding the Windows setup process is running really slowly, and it starts giving me errors. I'm finding that setup is also restarting a lot, and giving me a lot of errors like OOBE keyboard and OOBE settings errors. I assume this is happening because the setup GUI is probably not used to running in only 1 GB of RAM. After several restarts, I eventually get into a reset loop, where I'm just trying over and over again and getting the same results. Last time I did this, the setup process was slow, but at least it did work without errors. I can try to use the command prompt to try to set this up without the GUI, but I'm finding that a lot of the setup process has already happened, so I'm going to need to learn a bit more. While I was reading a bit about how to do this, I did keep restarting the GUI setup. And eventually, I was able to get to the final part of the setup. This next part did take a long time, but with Microsoft's soothing messages, reassuring me that eventually, this is probably going to work out. After waiting about an hour, I finally get to the Windows 11 desktop. And then about 20 seconds after that, the taskbar appears. Right away, it's clear this is going to be a sluggish experience. This is not Tiny 11's fault. Tiny 11 has been slimmed down to run in 2 GB of RAM. But this computer only has 1 GB, as well as a very old CPU. Tiny 11 does run a bit better than the previous full version of Windows that I had installed on here. I have to conclude that this is not a usable experience, though I'm glad I tried it, and this opens the door to trying more interesting operating systems on this machine. I'm now going to bring in my other Windows 11 computer, made from a Lumia phone from 2015. I set this up with Windows 11 on ARM in a previous video, with a keyboard, a mouse, and a second screen. This was a really good way to try out Windows 11. And then recently I saw on Kingdom 3533's channel, he made a video about an ARM version of Tiny 11 that he installed on his Lumia. This does seem like a perfect match between a tiny operating system and a tiny computer. Installing this is relatively smooth, thanks to the Lumia Windows on ARM project. They provide all the tools and guides you need to do this, though they have retired development on the Lumia tools, as they've moved on to installing Windows on other devices, such as the Microsoft Duo. I do have some concerns that this can only be done using their online repositories, though I do expect this will stay up for years or even longer. I just don't want to get stuck if I ever need to reinstall Windows 11 or even Windows 10 on a Lumia. With that done, the GUI setup is easy, and making a local account is not a problem. The whole process goes well, and I'm pleased with the result. The OS feels snappier than the previous Windows 11 that I had on here. The first Windows 11 install was not too bad, but Tiny 11 is even better. And being a phone, you can also make calls directly from the handset using Windows 11, but unfortunately not text messages. But that's okay for me because this is less of a phone and more of a computer for me. I've noticed that with Tiny 11, the dark theme has been removed. This seems like a bad idea, but easily fixed and no biggie. Otherwise, I'm very pleased with this. Tiny 11 is a great version of Windows 11, especially for a tiny little system like this one. Microsoft has also released a native ARM version of PowerToys that I'm installing right now, and this gives me some extra options. Last time, I was using this phone as a pseudo desktop computer with keyboard and mouse, and that was an amazing experience. I also really enjoyed testing the x86 64-bit CPU emulation, of which the integration was more impressive than I had expected, especially considering it was running on an old phone from 2015. I was disappointed by the lack of GPU support for the Lumia though. This time, I've been doing everything in handheld mode as I've been making this video. This has also been a really interesting experience, even though the Windows 11 user interface is not really designed to run on such a small device. I did spend some time using this as a phone on actual phone calls, and while it was briefly on an older build of Windows 10, I did also try text messaging. But the lack of text messaging on Windows 11 is a problem. I don't think this makes for a very good phone setup, but as a mini computer, it's outstanding. I have done some more benchmarking with the native ARM version of Performance Test. I saw an impressive performance increase to the previous install of Windows, though last time I was running with the dock and a second screen connected, and this could also be affecting the results. But either way, I'm pleased to see an almost 30% increase in CPU performance. I'm looking forward to finding more ways I can use this tiny computer in the future. For fun, I did also install the non-ARM version of the Performance Mark benchmark. This runs on the x86 emulation layer and benchmarks the emulation performance. And I compared this to the same software running on the VAIO to see what happens. The results are very interesting. The emulated CPU runs about 10 times faster than the native Core 2 Duo CPU in the VAIO. There's about a 9-year difference between the Core 2 Duo and the ARM CPU that's emulating x86 CPUs. This really shows us how much the world changed in that period after the Core 2 Duo, which was Intel's first 64-bit CPU, and just how much this later ARM CPU really mops the floor with it when emulating. These results really demonstrate the vintage nature of this VAIO UX, and that's not a bad thing. What's important with this VAIO is finding the right operating system that brings out the best in this amazing tiny computer. I'm reminded of this VAIO when I look at newer machines like the GPD Win 3, which really looks like it was inspired by the VAIO UX. But it's this Lumia computer that's really the standout in this video. With this stripped down Tiny 11 version of Windows, this is an incredibly niche but outstanding combination. While this VAIO is more of a classic vintage, that finding the right role in the future will really make it shine. If you're a fan of this channel, and next time you really enjoy a video, consider a donation on Patreon, or even a super thanks here on YouTube. This will help support some really great future videos. I really appreciate you being here and enjoying this channel. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.